आसम गलत पुष्पहासम जगत सन्निवासम सतादित्यवासम गदाचक्र शस्त्रम लसत् पीठवस्त्रम हसाचारु वक्त्रम भजेहम भजेहम रमाकंठहारं श्रुतिर्वार्तसारं जलान्तर्विहारं धाराभारहारं चिदानन्दरूपं मनोज्ञस्वरूपं त्रुतानेकरूपं भजेहं भजेहं जराजन्महीनं परानन्दपीतं समाधानलीनं सदैवानवीतं जगज्जन्महेतुं सुरानेककेतुं त्रिलोकैकसेतुं भजेऽहं भजेऽहं
थैंक यू प्रगति फॉर सिंगिंग ए नाइस डिवोशनल प्रेयर सॉन्ग फॉर अस नाउ I request to call upon Dr. E.S. Saravanan, Professor, Triple E Department and the Program Coordinator for this AICTE sponsored by AICTE to address the gathering.
Thank you, Rama Madam. Yeah, graceful to all of you. I am privileged to extend a warm welcome to all of you for the inaugural function of the AICTE sponsored STTP on recent developments and entrepreneurship in sustainable green energy technology and smart grid series C in online mode. First of all, I would like to thank our honorable chairman Sri Vishnu Raju, esteemed vice chairman R Ravichandran, enthusiastic and young secretary Sri K Aditya, eminent principal Dr K Lakshmi Prasad, for his constant support and encouragement to conduct this 6 days ACTE sponsored short-term training program. I am professionally overjoyed to take the opportunity to introduce our chief guest of the day, Dr. Ranjan Kumar, Associate Professor, Department of EEE, Indian Institute of Technology, Patna, for his valuable time with us to inaugurate this STTP. Welcome you, sir. I very much welcome to Dr. Lakshmi Prasad, principal, for this wonderful occasions. Whatever the event that is being organized by our EEE department, sir, given lot of encouragement, support to that event with the grand manner. Once again, I thank to our principal, welcome you, sir. I would also like to thank the Dr. K. Raidu, head of the and the members for the continuous support in making this STTP possible. Welcome all of you, sir. We are grateful to all the participants for their overwhelming responses. We have received a total 253 plus registration from this STTP across the 17 states from the various colleges, organizations in India, in addition one participants from Iraq. I sincerely hope that you will enjoy and find new directions in the field of research for this STTP. I am grateful for your participation and support. This STTP will provide to enrich the knowledge of faculties through interaction with the eminent personalities from industries and academics. The knowledge sharing will improve the teaching learning process to the students and benefits the society and also identify the new direction in the research field. Once again, I am most grateful for your participation and support. Thank you very much, everyone.
Thank you, sir, for expressing the importance of the program. Now, I'd like to introduce Dr. K. Raidu, sir, professor, head of the department, EEE, BVRIT, Nasapur. Sir has completed his PhD from JNTU Hyderabad and have over 16 years of teaching experience. Has published 22 papers in national and international journals. He specialized in the fields of power systems, computer techniques in power systems, and soft computing techniques in power systems. Now, I request sir to address all the participants.
Thank you, madam, for your introduction. Nice introduction. Thank you, respected Chairman Sir Sri K. Vishnu Raju Garu, SVS, Vice Chairman Sri Ravichandran Rajagopal Sir, SVS, Secretary Sir, Sri K.V. Aditya Sir, and our beloved Principal, Dr. K. Lakshmi Prasad Sir, and today's Chief Guest, Arun Kumar Behara Sir from IIT Patna, Deans, Heads of the Departments, and my dear faculty, and very importantly, the participants across India, hearty welcome to the short-term training program, recent developments and entrepreneurship in sustainable green energy technologies and smart grids. A hearty welcome to you all from the Department of EEE BVRIT. First, I would like to thank the management, administration for their continuous support and encouragement towards organizing this STTP. Department of Electrical Engineering is started in the year 1997 with an intake of 40 students and increased 60 in the year 2002 and increased 120 seats in the year 2012. Department of Electrical Engineering started two PG programs, M.Tech in Electrical Power Systems and Electrical Power Engineering and Power Systems, based on the expertise available in the department. Both UG and PG programs of EEE department are accredited by NBA 2009-13 and 17, and NAC in the year 2009-13 and 17. Our strength is we have well qualified and dedicated faculty. Non-teaching and very good professors, associate professors with sound knowledge in areas like microgrids, smart grids, integration of renewable energy sources and electric vehicles. The Department of Electrical Engineering is having a very good R&D funding projects, more than 3 crores from external agencies like DST, AICT and JNTH, Research Council of Norway, Avigni Renewable Energy Systems, India Private Limited. BVRIT, EEE department also known for solar energy technologies, having the state-of-art PV solar modules, testing facilities sponsored by Elkem Solar Norway, and it offers performance testing of solar PV modules, training and consultancy services to executives these solar projects. We installed 450 kilowatts rooftop solar power plant in the campus, and it will be generating around 2000 units a day, which meets 50% of the electricity consumption in the college, and complete the operation and maintenance taken care by the department faculty only. Coming to this STTP, the title itself very clearly stating that we are focusing on entrepreneurship development in green energy technologies for electrical students. This is possible only when the faculty is aware about latest technologies and developments in the sector. Technologies development, particularly solar and electric vehicles, in terms of R&D technology, we have invited the resource person from reputed organizations like IITs and NITs only. I hope you will enjoy all the 11 sessions, which starts from 19th to 24th of this month. Hope this STTP will give you the knowledge, information required towards green energy developments in India. And we are going to conduct the one more FDP, which is in continuation to this Series C, that is Series D, in the next month. After that, AICT has sanctioned one more, that is FDP, Faculty Development Program, on the area electric vehicle components, technologies, challenges, and future development, in the name of Dr. Pramila Madam. So I hope you all will continue to learn the things from this STTP also. I wish you all the very best to all the participants and also congratulates the coordinators and all the department staff. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable inputs. Now, I'd like to introduce Dr. K. Lakshmi Prasad Garu, the principal of B.B. Raju Institute of Technology, Nasapur. Sir previously worked as a principal and dean in Geetham Institute of Technology, Visakhapatnam. He did his graduation from JNTU Anantapur and post-graduation from IIT Bombay. He pursued his doctoral and research work at IIT Bombay. Now, I request our principal, sir, to address the gathering.
Thank you, madam, for introducing. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, sir.
Our chairman, Sri K.V. Vishnu Raju Garu, vice chairman, Sri Ravichandran Rajagopal Garu, our secretary, Sri K. Aditya Vishnu Garu, and the chief guest of the inaugural function and the main resource person and the keynote speaker for this inaugural lecture by Dr. Ranjan Kumar Behra Garu, my colleague and head of the department, who is the convener of this short-term training program on recent developments and entrepreneurship in sustainable green technologies and smart grids, Dr. K. Raidu Garu, and the coordinator for this entire program, Dr. S. Saravanan Garu, and most importantly, the participants. A very good morning to you all and a warm welcome to this short-term training program which is being conducted online. And this is the third program that we are doing it under this short-term training program by the Electrical and Electronics Engineering Department during this pandemic period. And in all the previous versions also, the participation was overwhelming because of the resource persons the department had chosen. And I'm very happy to see that the entire fraternity of the resource persons is a blend of the academicians, research organizations, and the industry. That's how the department had chosen the resource persons so that the participants will be enriched in the technologies which are being followed in the institution. We are not bringing something vague to any of the participants. The moment Dr. Raidu Garu talked about the solar, which we initiated almost 7-8 years back, and now which we are doing fully in the campus. So these are all the green initiatives that the institute has taken, and the same way we are really moving ahead. And I really thank all the participants for really choosing this program and attending this program. I'm sure that after 5 days of the program, you will be enriched with sufficiently with the knowledge and on the sustainable green technologies and smart grids. Coming to the institution, BVRIT Narsipur was established in the year 1997 with an annual intake of 120 in the undergraduate programs. From there, the journey over the past 25 years, if you take it 23 years, it's so overwhelming that now today we are offering undergraduate programs in basically 12 specializations, 12 basically disciplines in the undergraduate program and 8 specializations in postgraduate program. And we cater to the needs of all the people of the society in such a way the institution is not biased towards any of the technologies. You name any branch of engineering, we do have that in our campus. Apart from civil, mechanical, chemical, biomedical engineering, pharmaceutical engineering, computer science, ECE, EEE basically, and then basically artificial intelligence and machine learning, data sciences, computer science and business system. So we are having a diversified basically the courses in the campus, and we believe that giving that diversified thing nowadays, more or less we are closely slowly moving towards the interdisciplinary learning, and the line, basically the divide line between the branches is slowly wiping out, and it's as good as the students are expected to have that interdisciplinary mindset when they proceed into their career. So they are a perfect location for such type of interdisciplinary learning is BVRIT Narsipur. And mainly the institution's core values lies with basically the ethical values the management inculcated into the faculty and students. That's just one of the prime strengths of the institution. And then the faculty, as usual, the backbone of the institution, we are almost reaching to right now 30% of our faculty are doctoral degree holders, and slowly moving towards because our now objective is moving towards more in that direction, and that has been taking up now the shape. And already the institution as a whole is being accredited by NAC, and each individual disciplines are all the eligible disciplines are accredited by NBA, and we have completed the first cycle of the autonomous status and now moved into the second cycle of the autonomous status, and slowly moving towards making this institution as a basically as a hub for as a technical hub for higher learning. So with that motto, the institution is striving very hard to move towards that goal, basically. And this program is one program in that direction that we have taken it up. And I am sure that all of you will enjoy this program and kindly share your feedback. Your feedback is so valuable for us. And to really, what you call it, as to improve the things, whatever we are doing. With this, I once again thank Dr. Ranjan Kumar Behra Garu for accepting the invitation, and we wholeheartedly welcome sir for this inaugural meeting. And kindly, please kindly remember that we are right now working on a wonderful DST project on energy efficient buildings, being one of the partners in that, basically BVRIT Narsipur, and then basically from IIT Delhi, basically Professor Sukumar Mishra Garu is also one of the main principal investigator in that, and then we have IIT Roorkee as one of the partners from architectural department. So we three together working very important in the, which is basically led by Dr. Sukumar Mishra Garu from IIT Delhi, basically. So apart from that, as already the HOD has pointed out, the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering is taking up number of research projects and consultancy services, and being very much having expertise on solar technologies, and catering to the needs of in and around Hyderabad. Our people are really working very hard to really reach it to the society level. So with this, I once again welcome all the participants to this 5-day short-term training program. And I again once again thank Dr. Ranjan Kumar Garu. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Thank you all. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much, sir, principal, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable speech and inspiring us. Now, it's time to call upon our guest of honor and our keynote speaker, Dr. Ranjan Kumar Behra, Associate Professor, Department of EEE, IIT Patna. Sir has completed his PhD from IIT Kanpur, and also his M.Tech from the same university, IIT Kanpur. Sir has a vast teaching experience, and he has published 11 papers in national and international journals and presented 30 plus papers in national and international conferences. And his areas of interest are control of electrical drives, design and fabrication of power electronic circuits, application of nonlinear control theory, to power electronics and electric drives, pulse width modulation techniques for power electronics. Sir has guided many PhD scholars and he had many awards and honors like senior member in IEEE committee. And he has been invited by many colleges and universities to be as a session chair at many IEEE international conferences. And very happy to say, sir is a reviewer of many international journals like IEEE Transactions on Industrial Electronics, IEEE Transactions on Industry Applications, IEEE Transactions on Power Electronics, IET Power Electronics. And he also delivered many guest lectures, seminars, and acted as keynote speaker for many academic programs. Now, I'd like to request sir to address the gathering.
Thank you very much. I must thanks to the Shravan inviting me. And I am very thankful to the Sri Vishnu College. Especially, I visited to Mambaram once. I said the beauty of that college is that I have read when I entered the college, I have read one proverb that knowledge is for the society. We should not be very proud for the knowledge. So I am very thankful to Principal Sir, Dr. Lakshmi Prasad Garu, and all other teachers and the management of the Rajiv Institute of Technology. So most of the time in India, as I visited to many places, I find the technological revolution, what is developing in India, mainly, we try to gather the knowledge from other and we try to implement here. But the situation in India are completely different as per other countries is concerned. That is why here, whatever we will develop, and that is that according to our environment, we must develop that technology. So when I came back USA after my postdoctoral fellowship and came to appear the interview in IIT Patna, and they never asked me what I did here in India. Everybody, all the expert members, they asked me what you have done in USA. Whereas I worked so hard in India, which is one of the technology we transport to Indian Railway. So it was very big work where it is consulting with 4 countries we consulted to develop that project. So that is why in India, when we develop here, it is most important that our people, our place, and what are the user specifications, we try to develop that. And this way, the Indian entrepreneurship can be improved. And today, I am very happy that the coordinator, Dr. Shravan, asked me to speak about power electronics design. Especially when we go for design, nobody is interested to design. They want to purchase something and add to their system. But here, we develop everything. By our own students, they develop the things and we utilize, which is very, very sustainable and very robust. So that way, the technology, although today is very interdisciplinary, we work in many fields like wireless power, smart home design, smart grid, high power drives for vehicle drives, and many vehicles. And our students, they have developed also a electric vehicle, which is 20,000 rupees. Everybody can they have in the village. So this is under development stage. So we develop many things here. At the same time, we must see what are our users. That is most important. So with this, I thank everyone for inviting me to be a chief guest and also inviting me for keynote speaker. So we will discuss many things in the keynote speaker, in this keynote lecture, and it will be beautiful, so much insight into the design. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We are highly privileged to have you as our chief guest and our keynote speaker for this program. Now, concluding the inaugural session, I'd like to invite Mr. P. Chandrababu sir, Assistant Professor, Trichy Department, BVRIT Nursapur, and organizing coordinator of the program to say out of thanks to all.
Yeah, thank you, madam. Thank you very much. So welcome to honorable chief guest, Dr. Ranjan Kumar Behra, Professor, Department of Tribhuvi, IIT Patna, respected dignitaries, faculty members, and participants. It is one of the important day in the history of Tribhuvi Department. Today we have hosted the AICT sponsored SCDP program series C. So in this section, so total 253 plus participants from 20 different states participating in this program throughout the India, and one participant from Iraq is this is the huge success in itself. So on behalf of our Tribhuvi Department, I take this opportunity to express our sincere thanks to Dr. Ranjan Kumar Behra sir, gracing this session and immediate acceptance of our request as a chief guest. So his presence today in this function has immensely enhanced its importance. We are extremely grateful to you, sir, for your insightful address. I am so thankful a huge support received from principal sir, HOD sir, and faculty members. Finally, thanks to program coordinator Dr. Charanwan sir and organizing committee for making this AICT SCDP inauguration program a grand success and provide eminent speakers from IITs, NITs, and even foreign professors also. We invited, we arranged one section out of this 6 days SCDP program. I hope you will gain good knowledge after completion of this SCDP series C. So thanks you all, and have a good day. Thank you.
Now
I hand over the section to Rama madam.
Now, with special excitement, that I'm pleased to welcome our speaker, Dr. Ranjan Kumar Behra Garu, Associate Professor, Department of Tribhuvi, IIT Patna, to kickstart our first session on topic Design and Fabrication of Power Electronic Circuits. We are welcoming you, sir.
Thank you very much. So, so I have shared my screen. Can you see this? Hello?
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Sir, it's visible, sir. It's visible.
Okay. So should I put my video on or off?
That is up to you, sir.
If you're having very good signal, means to turn on your video.
Okay. So let us turn on. Okay. Whenever there is anything, so please let me know. I will try to again explain that one or anything. So I am very thankful to everyone, especially your institute and the coordinator of this program. So this is my best favorite subject, and this is the first time somebody asked me to speak about. So design and fabrication of electronic circuit. So I can tell you, although we procure many power electronic circuit or we do in the breadboard level, but actually designing a power electronic circuit is the biggest challenge today in India also. So if you see above 100 kVA inverter testing for the solar power is not available. Super. Yes. Sir, is it audible to everyone?
Sir, it is audible. Please, sir.
Sorry for the, yes, it's audible, but its voice is somewhat, it's having not loudy.
Oh, okay. Can you hear me now?
Yes, presently it's okay, sir.
Okay, if not, then I will turn on audio in my mobile, okay?
Okay, sir.
So like that we can do. So if this is not audible, please let me know. You can interrupt anytime. Okay. So when I joined in my M.Tech and PhD program in IIT Kanpur, my guide told me to design a high power converter for Indian Railway. And Indian Railway, if you see in the big, that WP7, which is a AC coach, and the alternating current drives are used there in that WP7. So my guide asked me to design a 15 kVA inverter, three-level multi-level inverter. And I tried in many ways for 3 years. Till 3 years, I could not able to design. Something is not working. Sometimes switch will fail. Sometimes the capacitor will fail. So it was so complicated circuit. And then I visited to Darmstadt, then ABB Switzerland, then IIC Bangalore, and try to design. And only for designing this inverter took 4 years of my PhD study. So, but this is when you design an inverter with such a high power, like Indian Railway, we use 6000 HP engine. And designing for such a huge circuit is really challenging today. And when you design also, you accommodate within the train engine, you should not be bigger than that. It should be lower than small size. So that is also an important. And third thing is robustness of the circuit. Even though there is so much vibration, that is important. Another one, the temperature variation. Temperature starts in India from 5 degrees. Okay, someplace 5 degrees or 2 degrees. Up to 60 degrees temperature, your circuit must remain there. So here, in this special, before going into multi-level, this is my journey that I worked all this place. And we work on solar, wind, power electronics drives, wireless power, smart grid, electric vehicle design. And we implemented nearly 10 projects across the world, many places in the USA, in India, in many villages, we implemented this one. And the technology is still used. And also, we work on the LED driver, all the other things. And we have a book, Power Electronic Drives and Advanced Application. Recently it came, so it will be available soon. So today we will discuss the outline is general structure, and then power electronics design, then controller, three-phase, three-level, then distributed converter. If we see a power electronic circuit, we have an input, variable or fixed, or you have an output, and by using sensor from input and output, you control this converter. That is the complete unit of the power electronic circuit. And that is why If you see the evolution takes place from 1900 to 1988, where IGBT was invented by Jayanta Baliga, one of the IIT Chennai alumni, who has developed IGBT first time in the world. And he is the one of the 10 revolutionary in the field of semiconductor revolution. So that is why he got the prestigious Semiconductor Revolutionary Award from the the US president. So the power electronics is a multidisciplinary. You need to know the thermal management, you need to know the power system, you need to know the communication, signal processing, electromagnetic control system, protection, and computing. DSP, everything come into picture. So when do we go power electronic component selection? First thing, when you design a, for example, you are designing a 1 megawatt solar plant. So how you will design the power? Can you design a 1 megawatt rated inverter? You cannot design. So you need to design many modular inverter and connecting different power, a cascaded mode of connection, you can do that. So for that, first thing is device selection is the most important thing. Then power IGBT, power diodes, then auxiliary design, that capacitor, inductor, and bus bar structure. Then how to drive these switches is very important thing, that is called the gate driver board and design. Then the protection circuit. So how to design this one? The first iterative approach is, first one is your specification. That the specification is that first you take the specification, for example, 15 kVA specification. Then you design the physical layout, will be, and you have to design the thermal, how to dissipate the heat from this one, and then electromagnetic interference, then power drives, then controller, protection, design, packaging. If you are happy, then you can build and verify and test it. These are all the equipment you require. You can see here on the right hand side, I have given one circuit, which is nothing but the complete, the different component of that power electronic circuit. So if you see first, generally, we have like this power switches. These are looks like this, a MOSFET. MOSFET, you can see, here the voltage rating and current rating, all these things are given according to the data sheet. You can find out. So what is your voltage level, accordingly you can choose. Similarly, you can see this is a Semicron IGBT module. You can get Mitsubishi, many companies they are having. And each module generally have two switches. One is upper IGBT and second one is the lower IGBT. And that are two are connected, and you can have the two gate driver, which is in the top. You can see there are two gate drivers. So how to select? For example, I have a DC link voltage of 750 volt. So I choose the voltage rating as a 1200 volt, so that higher voltage, always the lower voltage can be accommodated in the higher voltage. Similarly, the current of 100 ampere at 25 degree centigrade and 80 ampere at 85 degree centigrade. So accordingly, you can choose the current and voltage rating. So then there are different small signal or low power circuits are required. And those circuits are the biasing circuit or the driver circuits. So this driver circuit, they are nothing but we have a small small. It is, you can see that they are called the driver circuit, which operate from 12 volt to 18 volt. So these driver circuit only used to turn on or the turn off of the device. So to turn on and turn off the device, you can see that this is a small power supply, a 15 volt power supply, plus or minus. So in a op-amp circuit, you required plus minus 15 volt. You design a center table capacitor and a rectifier. Then you have a regulator. From the regulator, you get plus 15, minus 15. And this is the design of the PCB. And this is the complete design of the hardware. So you can understand the simple biasing circuit. We can use it. And then driver board. In our time, I remember, it was very difficult to design a driver board. Nowadays, the driver boards are available by many companies. They are providing IGBT driving circuit. But in our time, I remember a driver board design, it took 6 months time. And one after another stage of analysis, then how somewhere the signal frequency may vary, somewhere the gate driver current is 0.6 milliampere, but we get less than that one. So how to improve the current, how to improve the voltage, all these things are taken into consideration before designing. But nowadays, these gate driver boards are available by Semicron, by ST Microelectronics, by ABB. There are many driver boards are there. We can use those driver boards. And generally, if you see a single phase converter, which is rated up to 5 kilowatt, you can use this inverter circuit. And this simple inverter is controlled by the computer on through OpenRT. We can connect to a inverter circuit. You can see here, this is a single phase inverter. You can see the two IGBTs are here in the below, and the DC link voltage, you can see big capacitor is here, which is DC link voltage, and they are controlling, there are the striper boards which controls this IGBT. This is very simple to design. Then when we have a measurement of the voltage, we use the voltage transducer or voltage sensor. This voltage sensor require certain voltage, and these voltages are this. You can see that this is the internal circuit of the LV25P is the voltage sensor, and this is the power supply for voltage sensor. So what is important in the voltage sensor is the testing, whether the voltage sensor is linear or not. Sometimes all the voltage sensor, you may not get like this linear curve. Why? Why this linear test is required? Because you need to find out what is the gain. So what you do, we have a voltage, you go on increasing the voltage and measure the input voltage and output voltage. Then you get a slope. In that relationship, you can actually multiply with, when you measure lower voltage, you can multiply by the gain, you will get the actual voltage. So similarly, the current transducer also, you must test with DC voltage. Okay, plus minus, you can see here, this is the current transducer testing. And this is the
sir, Ranjan output. Sir, sorry for the disturbance. Sir, yes. Ranjan sir. Sir, I think your fan is rotated in full speed. Maybe it's possible to reduce the fan speed, sir. I think it's having the disturbance occur due to fan.
I don't have fan. It is actually my AC only running. There is no fan here.
Okay. Some disturbance occur, sir. I don't know how it's occurred.
So can I join from my mobile? That will be good. It will be
okay. Sound sir.
Will be very clear.
Yes, sir. We have some disturbance occur, some background disturbance occurs, sir. Many of the participants also complained to them, so voice is not clear.
Let me
okay, sir. Wait for 1 or 2 minutes. You join with your mobile also. It's no problem, sir.
I want to
We are waiting. Our participants will wait. We are waiting for you, sir. Dear participants, wait for 2 minutes. Dear participants, can I join?
Now is it audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's audible, sir.
It is okay?
It's okay, sir. It's okay, sir.
So this we are going.
Hello. Hello, sir.
You can hear me now?
Yes, yes. Sir, it's voice is audible, sir.
Okay, thank you, sir. So this current transducer design, similarly, you must test by using positive current and negative DC current, and accordingly you get the output. And design the, find out what is the gain of the system. So actual current you can get by measure, because it is reduced current, actual current you can multiply the gain, you will get the actual current. So this is what the protection circuit, solid state relay we use for the protection circuit, and these are the conductor. So this way you can do this one. I have seen during our time, we used to have the fuse wire as a protection circuit. Now, the controller, there are different kind of controllers, and I will tell detail of this controller. One is your Opel RT controller, so where you can do a real-time simulation in this one, as well as the hardware interface. And there are also the controller, which is called D-Space Micro Labor, where you can design in Simulink platform, and you can just just communicate with the D-Space board, and it will channelize, it will take your input and output. And DSP controller, and D-Space also, there was another controller, and FPGA, there are controllers. So when I in my PhD, I got the challenge, this one, the IGBT based high power traction drive converter design. So what is the converter rating? Is around 70 kVA, okay? And 115 kVA. IGBT rating was 3.3 kV and 400 MPa. So you can understand, we can see that it is such a huge converter need to be designed, and the efficiency must be around 90%. So generally, all the drives we purchase from the foreign country, but it was designed in India. And that is how this is the, if you see the auxiliary converter, there are a controller, low switch, battery charger, converters, and then the cabinet for this one. If you see in the present status, the Indian Railway, if you see the front engine, that is the drive, the heart of locomotive. And almost all AC drive used in Indian Railway are imported from Siemens or G. Or Alstom. So you see, this is the traction motor. And you have seen in the Indian Railway that there are four motors. You can see in the front two, and two. Here also in the rear two. These two are controlled from the traction inverter. And my job was to develop this traction inverter and main rectifier circuit, which is connecting 25 kV pantograph and coming through a step down transformer, then main rectifier, then inverter circuit. So this is the rating, the power converter rating, that the input is a single phase 22.5 kV, okay? And the region to braking with the four quadrant operation. So now, what is the challenge? Challenge is that our traction drive is 6,000 SP. And how to design this high power switching converter, which is most challenging for this type of drive. And real-time digital controller and integration and deployment is another problem. So if you see the traction motor, we take from the cantilever and 25 kV cantilever contact, and then it comes to the traction motor. So this fabrication of this three-level converter was given as it was a very big challenge during those period. You can see that three-level, we know two type of converter. One is a two-level converter, which is plus DC. Output will be minus DC or plus DC. That means if you see a square wave output from the input, that is called the two-level converter. And a two-level converter contains different kind of harmonic, third harmonic, fifth harmonic, seventh harmonic. What is harmonic? Harmonic is nothing but unwanted power supplies along with your the most useful power supply. For example, the harmonic is like a pollution to the supply. For example, we have a river. When you channelize all the drains to the river became polluted. So similarly, this is a three-level converter. That means this three-level converter will, you will have plus VDC, zero, and minus VDC. And that will give you more accurate towards a sinusoidal waveform. This multi-level converter design was a big challenge. You can see that initially we used all these wiring. You can see that here below, there are six IGBTs, okay? Each IGBT has each module has two IGBT, total 12 number of switches. This black color, you can see here. And initially, we connected them by using wires. And in the middle, the capacitor, first recovery diodes are connected here, and all these wires are connected and taken out for the power supply. And this same converter, you can see that in the top, all the gate driver circuit, and below is the switching circuit. So when we design like this, the upper one and lower one, you can see that lower one is operated at high switching frequency. That is why there is electromagnetic interference with this driving circuit. So how to avoid that one? So in between that one, we put a conducting plate. That plate is grounded to the supply ground. And that way, you can remove some of the, but it was not properly designed because of the wiring structure. So you can see this is our three-level converter, which is feeding this DC to this induction motor. And in those period, we used to have a PCL208 card as a controller. You can see this computer is open And in the PCI slot, this controller is connected there. And that is used by using C, C++. We use it to develop the program, and that was running. So when you see here, this converter, although a three-level converter, but it is acting like a two-level converter. You can see from the waveform, it is behaving exactly like a two-level converter. And the sine wave or sine wave current, you can see that the current is not sine wave. It contains a lot of ripple. And this is a utility-friendly converter. Both current and voltage should have a sinusoidal, and they are in phase, like our maximum power transfer theorem. When you transfer the maximum power, when load resistance is equal to the source resistance. So when these both are matching each other, you have maximum power transfer. Exactly in a power electronic circuit, when your cos phi or power factor is 1, then this is called the utility friendly or maximum power transfer. Although it is happening, but you can see that this converter, this creates a lot of noise in the current. So that is why there is due to this inductance. When you connect a wire, wire has appreciable amount of stray inductance. And if the stray inductance in the line is less than 9 millihenry or nanohenry, you do not require any kind of the snowball circuit. So that is why the parasitic oscillation takes place. Second one, there is electromagnetic interference which affect on the low voltage circuit, like gate driver circuit. And there is maximum overshoot in the DC voltage. And there are spikes in the semiconductor device. And there are also some proximity effect due to this switching system. So that is what this fabrication was the challenge. So how to design this one? First design is the bus wire connection, how you will connect these switches. You can see there are 9-7 layers we designed for this one. You can see the top is one layer, first layer. First layer is connected the positive of this DC volt. Okay. And the second one, you can see only it is connected to one IG or the clamping diode with this one with the center. And then third is from center tip of the capacitor to the clamping diode. And the fourth one is the lower one is this the clamping diode. Then seventh layer is negative DC bus. So this way, we have seven layer PCB need to be designed to design this converter. So what is the cost per advantage? First thing is, it increases the capacity and lower inductance value. So these are the how it is mounted in the heat sink, and there are seven layers, and you need to design the connection. So if you see here, this is the bus bar. Bus bar, you can see that in the top layer, connected with the positive DC link and all the top switches. Then below one, it's only this black color or the points are the connecting. So like that, seven layer PCB is designed. And it is, you can see that this PCB, all the IGBT are mounted on this heat sink. And you can see that they are symmetrical. And the by using bushings and Teflon connection, we have connected different layer of this PCB. So this fan used here, right? So just the system, okay, cooling. So what, how to design the distilling? First thing is the designing of this distilling capacitor voltage rate. So we know this one is our voltage, 415 volt RMS. So for sinusoidal PWM, so distilling voltage must be 681 volt. For space vector, it must be 587 volt. So like this, we can design the distilling accordingly. A capacitor voltage rating can be checked. So then we have a distilling capacitor calculation. How to calculate distilling capacitor? If you see here, this is the ripple content in the capacitor current. And according to this capacitor current, we can design the capacitance calculation. And this is the worst case where you can see that 4%, ripple is 4%. And this is the capacitor formula that you can find out the capacitance as 750 microfarad. Because we have taken the 15 kVA converter and Imax is 36 ampere. And then we find out what is the capacitance. And after that, you have a two capacitor, because both the capacitor, electrostatic resistance they have, they are different. So how to equalize these two capacitors? Because sometimes if you see, one capacitor will charge very high, other capacitor will charge very low. So how to equalize this capacitance? By using this breeder resistance. So we need to design this two equalizing resistor so that they can maintain equal voltage during loading and unloading condition of the converter. So then thermal design is the biggest aspect, that what is the size of heat sink, what is the size of fan, whether it is hydrogen cooling, whether this is air cooling, whether it is oil cooling, the different kind of cooling. Accordingly, we need to design that one. So we consider 10 kilohertz switching frequency, and then we have phase opposition carrier modulation scheme, and the line to line voltage 415 volt. So peak load current is 36 ampere, power factor is a 1. So then by using the thermal, each module component is designed in this, the thermal design. According to the thermal calculation, I have not given all the calculation here because it will become very lengthy. So this thermal calculation, according to this calculation, the heat sink size is calculated as 215 into 30 into 75 mm3. And air flow rate is 12 meter per second has been chosen to exactly extract the heat from the switches. And this is the calculation of the all the power loss, everything is calculated here. And this is the mounting of the voltage. You can see that voltage sensor is the middle one, and both two current sensor. Why two current sensor? Because for a balanced load, IA plus IB plus IC is equal to 0. So if you IA and IB, IC you can find out easily. That is why these two current sensors are used. And this is the IGBT driver circuit and seven layer bus wire circuit. And this is the cooling fan. You can see that encoder cam lockout circuit is the below one. Lockout circuit means, you know that the IGBT in one leg, the two IGBTs are there. They will turn on at any time. There may be dead short circuit. That is why we have given lockout between that two. And this is why you have a design And all these driver circuit are connected in this here. You can see that there are 12 switches and 12 drive circuits. Driver circuits are connected here and 7-layer bus. And this is designed and tested in the laboratory. You can see that this is the laboratory. After doing this laboratory testing, you can see that all IGBTs are placed and there is a 7-layer bus bar. And this, you can see this is the region. You can see that there is 3-level region where you can see that 5-level line to line, okay? In the line to line is a 5-level. And then there are switching. Then you can see this current waveform below one in the current. So you can see that it is the voltage is more over nearly sinusoidal and current also nearly sinusoidal. And these are the different, the simulation and experimental results where you can see that both voltage and the current are unity power factor. And this is your DC link voltage, which is maintained constant irrespective of that. So in train, inside the train, if you see, there is a front end converter. Initially, this 3-level AC-DC converter was a DC, was a diode bridge rectifier circuit. So most of the time, the regenerative power you dissipate, and it is dissipated in the resistance block. But nowadays, all the drives, they have front end converter where the regenerative power is feedback to the source or the charge the battery or supply to the AC coaches of the train. So this, I have two converters, one 3-level converter in the front end, another 3-level converter in the motor end. And we used two PCs for controlling both the one converter, one PC, another converter is with a D-space board. So this complete unit is designed. You can see here, both the converter are here and then connected to this induction motor load. And this is the experiment. If you see the top view of this one, you can see that this computer controlling this converter. And this converter is supplied from this auto transformer, which is here there. And from the auto transformer, this is supplied to this converter. And this converter, it charges this DC link voltage. And this DC link is connected to another converter. If you go inside the train engine, these two converters are there. One is a front-end converter, another one is an inverter, which is controlling the machine drive. And this converter is controlled from this computer. And this induction motor is used as a load. And you can see there are rheostat and DC motor. They are connected as a loading rheostat, okay, for that DC motor. So this way, we design the complete the hardware of this multi-level converters. So the most important thing that when you design, what need to be understand? First thing is whether your computer, where you are using, whether this is having that computational capability or not. If there is no computational capability, sometimes you will get missing pulse in the gate driver. In that gate driver, you will most of the time you will miss many pulses in that one. And in that way, your complete system will destabilize. It will not be stable. So that is why most important thing to design the converter, then testing, how to test it. First thing is interlayer short circuit testing. Whether two layer when we connect, whether there is a short circuit. Second one, the gate driver testing, whether when there is a short circuit, it affects on the gate driver and the control circuit. And third one is the DC charging circuit. And fourth one, is the testing circuit, okay, testing all the converter, feeding a load and a source. So like this, we have done many experimental setup. You can see that these are, and you can see that this is a three-level result. And the both the voltage, the DC link voltage, you can see they both are constant. And there is no unbalance in the DC link voltage. They are constant. That is why the fabrication is a very important factor. And second thing, when you use proper by using bus bar, you can see that the current is sinusoidal. There is no spike. It is completely in phase with the voltage. And that is how you can see in this total harmonic distortion is less than, is around 3.2%. So then we have also developed the converter, a distributed converter for this three-wheeler. You can see that this is a sample three-wheeler auto, where there is nothing in that one, okay? Only three wheels are there and the front one is there. And we designed this one with proper gear and the transmitter one. You can see that this is the induction motor drive, where we put this induction motor here and driving this three wheeler. And now this induction motor and a converter is put here in this box, and this is feeding to your front wheel, and it is driving your auto rickshaw. So this three wheeler was designed, and now you can see this three wheeler collar, everything is very nicely designed, although it was so if you see this auto rickshaw, below this green one there are batteries and converters are there. And this is developed here. And you can see here that when you change from the neutral to first gear, second gear, third gear, and you can see that change in the torque and the power. And this is how the first gear to the fourth gear changes at different concepts altogether. Then we have also developed a small DC-DC converter start chip for the electric cycle. And in this electric cycle, you can see this wooden box is nothing but the charging circuit, all batteries, everything is there. And that is designed for this one. And then another circuit we designed, the electric tricycle for the old people. And this tricycle also designed based on this one. So how to design this modular inverter circuit? And we design a inverter circuit, which is 5 HP. We required the induction motor we designed, a high density induction motor. And that high density induction motor is 5 HP, 110 volt, 80 Hertz, single phase. And this one, how to design this one, which each block is one phase. That means you have a three phase, three leg, and three leg are distributed together, that one modular inverter. And their DC bus voltage is 200 volt, and output line current is 110 volt. Output current is 30 ampere. Accordingly, we choose the IGBT. And this is our three-phase open-end winding induction motor. You can see this each winding, induction motor has three winding, A dash, B, B dash, C, C dash. You can connect as a star or delta according to your connection. But we have three inverters, inverter A, inverter B, and inverter C. These are the three distributed inverter, a single phase. Why it is used? Because in electric vehicle application, when you have a three-phase inverter, if one inverter is not working, then whole inverter circuit, whole converter will not work. Where here, it is like a modular structure, and each inverter is a modular, and if there is some fault in the inverter, you can quickly replace this inverter easily. That is how this distributed inverter come into picture. And this distributed inverter are feeding to each winding. And why we have taken each winding? When you take each winding, the current handling capability of the inverter reduces, because each winding current will be 1/3 of the your total current rating. So that is how it will handle low voltage and low current. And that is why there will be, it is the most reliable circuit. And this three distributed inverter we designed for the induction motor drive used for the electric vehicle. And then we have a three inverter single phase feeding from the DC link voltage. And this inverter, you can see that the three inverters are connected here. And each module, you can see here, there are two IGBTs. Here two IGBT module, which is this white one, is your IGBT module. And there is a capacitor voltage for each module. Okay, in this black one is your capacitor module. And this is our driver board, which drives the circuit. And then we have a non-inverting amplifier, okay, for this driver board circuit. And then from here, you can take the output, okay? So rectifier and inverter, single phase inverter circuit is mounted in one block. So like in our electric, this is designed for the four-wheeler. In that electric block diagram, you need to keep all these inverters. So one, two, and three inverter, a bit less space, because below you have to put all the batteries for operating of this motor. So similarly, this is the inverter A is connected. Then we have a inverter B and inverter C. You can see this is the staircase, and we developed by using a wooden box. And below is C phase, and B phase is in middle, A phase on the top, and they are fed to the through the induction motor drive. So if you see here, this is our Opel RT, is the controller. The Opel RT, you can do both the thing, the real-time simulation, as well as you can also connect to the hardware for both hardware and software interface. And then these three single H-bridge inverter is here, one, two, three layer. And this is the load box. And three-phase induction motor below this table is connected here. And the performance is tested here in the laboratory. So if you see here, you can see this video, the loading from this inverter circuit. And there is a dynamo loaded, okay? So, this inverter is, when we design this inverter, this is tested actually. And you can see here the voltage. So slowly the induction motor is loaded by this dynamo, okay? So dynamometer is here, and this is our induction motor, and this is coupled with this dynamo load, and you can also create a different kind of loading by using this dynamo. And this is, you can see here, we are feeding from the inverter and controlling the speed of the induction motor. And when this is fully loaded, the induction motor stops. So you can see again this video that how this is loaded from or feed from the inverter circuit. You can see that there is a pulse, the square wave pulse, and this is driving this complete unit. Okay. So you can see that now it stopped. So now we are also designing the multi-phase induction motor drive for high power industrial drive. The multi-phase machine more than three phase. Already we know three phase machine. Three phase machine is well understood, and each phase is shifted from each other 120 degree phase apart. A phase, B phase is 120 degree, C phase is 120 degree. And here we use five phase induction motor because if you are engine, you have a ship engine in the middle of the sea, one of the phase in the ship engine is not working, then you can operate as a four-phase machine. You can also operate as a three-phase machine. And that is how you can have a fault-tolerant control. And also, because you have a more number of phases, your current rating will be reduced and vibration will reduce. There are many advantages, okay? So to mitigate that one, and if you see here, this is our multi-phase induction motor drive. And this multi-phase induction motor drive, you have to fault detection, then fault mitigation, then post-fault control also we can do. And here you can see here in the circuit, in this diagram here in the picture, this is a multi-phase machine, which is five phase, connected coupled with a DC machine, and this DC generator is coupled with this induction motor, multi-phase, and induction motor is coupled with a TECO generator, where it will measure the speed and give the feedback speed, okay? So this torque strategy of the multi-phase induction motor, if you see here, the starter current has a lower current. That is how you can have low current, a distributed current. Now, if you see here, in this experimental setup, we have here, this is a inverter circuit, this is a auto transformer connected to a rectifier circuit, and rectifier circuit is feeding to the five level voltage source inverter. You can connect to five phase three level, or five phase two level converter also. And this converter, you had what is a three level converter, five phase three level converter. And then you can also, we have a resistive bank here as a loading. And you can see that from this power analyzer, and we have a FPGA controller where you can also create a fault. You want to have a fault in one phase, it will work for that. So here is our five phase induction motor, and this complete unit is designed and implemented. So if you see here, we have a three-phase power supply, A, B, C phase, feeding to the rectifier circuit. And then we have a different sensors. And then we have an inverter circuit. And this inverter circuit is feeding to our multi-phase. And Opel RT used as the controller for the complete unit. And this, if you see here, you can see that the speed control and the torque control. Now, during the transient period at T0, as the speed is rising, you can see that there is a transient torque. As the speed moves smoothly or uniformly, there is a nearly zero torque, and little, if you see the average torque, it has some torque because of the inertia in the rotor, because rotor is having inertia. Because of that rotor inertia, there is some average torque is available because of that, to take care of that inertia. And then from T1 to T2, you increase the speed, okay? So you can see that from 500 RPM to 1000 RPM. When it is increased, you can see that the torque ripple, the torque have a transient. Then again, as soon as steady state reach, it comes to zero. So at this point, T2 time, we apply a torque of 10 Newton meter. So when you apply a 10 Newton meter torque, you can see that there is a small deviation in the speed at T2, but after T2, again, it goes to steady state. And at T3, we removed the torque. So torque is nearly zero. So at that time, you can see that there is a rise in the speed at T3. Again, it comes. So this test our closed loop system is stable, and it is according to our reference values. So this way, we can design the complete closed loop control. And this is a direct torque control, okay? So now, if you see here, this is a three-phase rectifier circuit. First thing, when we design a converter, what is the first step? First step is to design the rectifier circuit. And once the rectifier circuit, you load. For example, you design a 15 kVA or 15 kilowatt rectifier load. So load it up to 15 kilowatt, then you connect other circuit. So before testing that one, you should never connect with the inverter circuit. First, the rectifier circuit, then there is an inverter circuit or voltage source inverter, and then five-phase induction motor coupled with the DC generator load. And then you design the current sensors, and before putting the current sensor in the PCB, you first test each current and voltage sensor, whether their input-output response is linear or not. If it is not linear, then you find out core fitting and find out the equation, and accordingly, you find what is the gain, or else you will get always error voltage when you feed to the computer. So that is how, when there is error voltage, what will happen? This error voltage will destabilize the complete unit. And once the voltage and current sources are properly tested and you find out what is the gain in that one, then use that one in the real-time controller, like Opel-RT controller. And from Opel-RT controller, and through this DC-link voltage sensor and current sensor, you give the control signal to your inverter circuit. And this way, the complete unit is designed. So if you see here, this is our converter structure. You can see this is our Opel-RT, and this is our multi-level or five-phase, three-level converter, which our students, they have developed. And below is our induction motor load, and which is running here. And then complete unit is run and fabricated in the laboratory. So when we see here, what are the main components here? You can see that when you design a three-level inverter circuit, so what in each inverter, you can see there is a capacitors are connected here. Why capacitor is connected? When you have a low power signal, to remove the ripple, you need to have ceramic capacitor of 1200 picofarad capacitors are connected just to remove the ripple and the voltage or ripple and the switching signal. So that is you can remove by using small capacitor. That is why here in across the each switch we apply a capacitor to just nullify the ripple content in the switching ripple content. During switching time, when you are changing from plus VDC to zero or zero to minus VDC, there is a sharp change in this voltage, okay? So due to sharp change, it will have a large di by dt or dv by dt. So that will create a spark on the voltage waveform. So to take up this voltage waveform, and a capacitor are connected there. And these capacitors are supplied from the semicron. And these modules are supplied here. And then gate drivers are supplied from in this all this thing. And the on the top one is the connectors to the gate driver from the D space. Okay. So D space is the controller and feeding that D space control signal to the high power converter system. And there is the voltage and current measurement also you can do by using the tongue tester and the other devices, and the complete unit is designed. So if you see this video, you can understand that how this is, the voltage is applied here, and then you can see here, this is the DC link, and this is complete unit, how the motor is connected here and driving. Here you can see there are three-level converter in the three plus VDC, zero, and minus VDC. Okay. So the fault tolerant control also is possible. You can see that here is three phase, and even your converter and this machine, if the long distance, there is a reflective wave also. So to take care of that one, you need to twist the conductor one after another and then feed to the drive. And so that that like a transposition, transpose of the conductor we do in that big transmission line. Exactly here also, you can design in the similar way of the circuit. And here you see there are a few results where the first thing is the torque. What we applied? We applied a speed command from zero. This is the testing for four quadrant operation. Four quadrant operation means forward motoring, reverse motoring, forward braking, reverse braking. When you design an electric vehicle, you take in the front, again you take the reverse while rotating, like that, these four quadrant operations. Like a lift, that also, sometimes lift go up with people, with load and without load. Similarly, lift can come down with load, without load. Exactly here also, you see, we have applied a speed. And here, when I applied a speed here, so first it was zero. Now when I applied, you can see that during the transient period of the speed, you can see that there's a torque transient. When the speed is smooth or the under steady state, the torque is equal to zero. Again, when at the steady state speed, you apply a torque. So when you apply a torque at T2, you can see that the speed will decrease and try to maintain constant. Again, at T3, you applied a torque, and that time you can see that there is a dip again in this speed. But because it is a closed loop system, it maintains to operate at constant speed, actually. So similarly, here at T4, you remove the torque, or torque is withdrawn, applied torque is withdrawn. So when you remove the torque, you can see that the speed increases. You can see here, the speed increases, and at T5, you have applied a reverse speed. That means the plus 500 to minus 500 speed. You can see that during that period, again during transient period, this T5, this torque is having negative, okay? And then during steady state, there is constant. So similarly, below one is our current, and both the D axis and Q axis current, they are perpendicular to each other, okay? So that is what from here, you can see that the flux trajectory is like a Lissajous figure in case of our, when your two signal, which is perpendicular to each other, when you give to X and Y axis in a CRO, you will get a Lissajous figure. And sometimes we call this one as a phase trajectory. Okay. Designed many converters and in that this by using this one, and there are also many applications we did in the different places. There are like micro hydro turbine application and solar application, as well as in the wind turbine application. So,
Anjan sir, sorry for the disturbance.
So, thank you very much. If you have any questions or comment, I will be happy to clarify.
Dear participants, you are having any queries, unmute your audio and directly interact with our resource person, Dr. Ranjan sir. Or post the queries in chat box.
My email also I have given here. So you can send also to my email address.
Anyone having any queries, just to interact with our resource person, directly or unmute your audio.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Sir, you have used all the available gate driver circuit from Semicorn, as you have mentioned, that Skyper 32 Pro. But if someone wish to design the gate driver circuit by optocoupler, then he needs to provide the voltage as 15 volt or minus 15 volt for the turn on and turn off respectively. In that case, how one should design the voltage supply? Because for turning on the switch, the current requirement is very much high. So 7915 is not possible to use. So
now my students are using this one, the Skyper, but I never used Skyper. We designed ourselves by using optocoupler and then EXB841 driver. I think you must be knowing EXB driver are available. It is from 40 electric or somewhere, I forgot. And for that driver, you can there is inherently optocoupler is there, and you can design that one. When your current requirement is very high, you can use a buffer before supplying to the driver. Okay, so buffer state will increase your current capacity. Okay, so buffer is nothing but a op amp with unit gain. Okay, okay, so you use that one, you will see that you can improve your current also. So that is what don't use 741 buffer, use the Texas TL081 or TL084.
So any other participants? Okay, any other participants? Dear participants, sir. Any other participants having queries?
Sir, one more thing I want to ask. Yes, sir, for three-level neutral point clamped inverter, when I am using two defilling capacitor, so I need to balance the capacitor voltage.
Yes.
So what? So you have shown only one voltage sensor. So I think I need two voltage sensor to sensing both the capacitor voltage and maintaining its balance. So how do you do it?
Actually, I used one because the capacitor, I have designed a breeder resistance. Breeder resistance can become, you have to find out the electrostatic resistance from the data sheet capacitor, and then what is the voltage drop across that one and other voltage drop, and design a breeder resistance which will equalize both the capacitor voltage. So if the impedance drop across this, because two capacitor electrostatic resistance will never be same, so you design a parallel resistance that is called the breeder resistance. And when you design this breeder resistance, then that resistance you can try to make it equal voltage. And or else you have to use a chopper circuit. You have to get both VDC1 plus VDC2. You measure both. Then you use a chopper circuit for balancing. And that is very complicated, actually. So you can use by this process. You try with breeder resistance, and I will share the PPT with the college, the organization. I will share. They can share with you. If you have any doubt or anything, you can write me also. Okay, here we are.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Any queries, they can also write me, and I will answer or I will send the reply.
Sir, hello.
Hello,
sir. Sir, this is Suraj, sir. Actually, the doubt is regarding this is after the topic. I'm working on the bidirectional converter.
Okay.
I just wanted to know whether we can use the conventional MOSFETs for the bidirectional operation.
You can use that bidirectional converter by using two MOSFET. You can design that. And we are working on the matrix converter, and each switch is bidirectional. We are making like that one. So if you want to
So can we not use the single converter, single MOSFET for the bidirectional operation, sir?
No, single MOSFET, actually bidirectional converter, if you have a single MOSFET, the MOSFET diode is not so fast, internal diode, okay? If you want to operate your switch at 10 kilohertz, but the internal MOSFET of the of your MOSFET, internal diode is not very fast, okay? So because the internal diode is not very fast, you require the fast, both directions, same switching frequency, most of the time, the junction temperature will rise and MOSFET will fail. So that is why two MOSFET of equal characteristics, same company, okay? You should not use two company MOSFET. Same company MOSFET you must use. You have seen in our hardware, even diodes I used as a same IGBT I used as a diode. So what I did, I sorted the gate driver, only used the two diode only, because it will match the characteristics of IGBT. That is the main purpose. Or else you will think that, oh, you have designed very nicely, and after that you saw that it is not working. You will see that the junction temperature will rise. It will not known to us, but there will be mistake automatically. Okay?
Okay, sir. But if it, without using the diode, if you employ some process like active rectification or synchronous rectification,
you can use the fast recovery diode instead of that.
Okay, but
fast recovery.
I'm also going through some of the articles like active rectification and synchronous rectification, but I'm not getting the full idea about those rectification processes.
So can you just send me your circuit? I will tell how to fabricate. Okay? Just you send me in my email address your circuit. I will I will tell how to fabricate that. Okay?
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Sure, sir. Thank you.
Mr. A. Karthikeyan, unmute your audio and interact with our resource person. A. Karthikeyan. Mr. Karthikeyan, if you unmute your audio, otherwise to enter in this chat box.
Hello, sir.
Yes,
please. Sir, can I speak to Kumar Behra, sir?
Yes, sir.
Please. Sir, Ranjan Kumar Behra, sir?
Yes, sir.
Please. Sir, I'm Dr. Snooker also from Parvathipuram Pritham Engineering College, sir. I'm belongs to EC department. Earlier, worked with you, sir. Hello?
Sir, tell me.
Actually, sir, personally, I want to do research in power electronics, sir.
Okay.
Sir. That's why, can you give me some advice to get some funding project relevant to power electronics and wireless communications, sir.
Oh, power electronics and wireless communication.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So this is, they are now using in the all smart grid is based on that only.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Different protocol, and there are just last week I was speaking about the IoT based system design,
yes,
energy management system design. So you can use any kind of converters and the switching structure, and then you can also add all the communication and sensors into this. So you can write a smart building, smart grid, smart electric vehicle design, even the charging circuit also nowadays they are having by using communication network.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So you can just write me an email, so, or you can call.
Sir. I want to put you some person.
Mr. Karthikeyan, if you are willing, you ask the questions. Otherwise, to type the question in this chat box also, it's accepted. Hello. Hello. Sir, Rajan, sir.
Hello. No question, sir. No question. No question, sir.
This. Dr. Ranjan sir, thank you sir for accepting our invitation and give a very wonderful lecture to our participants. Thank you sir. It's having your lecture. It's having very practical and a lot of things are discussed, either this two wheeler, bicycle or tricycle, even though it's auto rickshaw, it's having discussed a lot, and it's having you just to tell you informed them to having itself what are the difficulty we are facing to design the circuit also. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for your wonderful presentation on behalf of BVRIT. Once again, I thank for accepting our invitation. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
The dear participant, already the feedback posted in this chat box, plus the WhatsApp groups, it will enable up to 12:30. Better to complete your feedback in forenoon session before 12:30 p.m. And the next session will start on exactly so 1:30 p.m. The next session, the resource person is Dr. Kirib Babu from MANIT. It's having start will exact at 1:30 p.m. today. Thank you very much. We'll meet on 1:30 p.m. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Ranjan, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.